He's got asbestos fingers. Haven't you, dear? And we are actually going to use this. This is not just a demonstration. We're actually going to try and take the liquid from this, and we're going to take it home and we're going to ferment it. So we'll see how it tastes with the oak barrel and the charcoal and the fire and the wood all adding their own special flavours. And you should get an aroma, a smell now. How much do you want? Oh, yes. See, it's changing colour almost immediately. When the crushed malt hits the hot water, then it reactivates all the enzymes in the grain, and what we're getting now is the starch being converted into sugars. And you can see this is going to start going golden brown, and it will just go more and more and more golden brown. We'll end up with a half a bucket full of sugars that we can then ferment up. And it doesn't matter about the bits of wood and all the bits and pieces in it, because we're going to, all the solid bits will settle to the bottom, and we just want the liquid. It's like a volcano, you know, and it's just sort of, and you can actually see it's a slightly darker brown there. Now we've got to keep this temperature up for about 15, 20 minutes, maybe half an hour or 40 minutes. Maybe about 40 minutes, he says. And then we'll get the most of the sugars that we can out of the grain. It's already beginning to taste a little bit sweet. This is the skill, really, is to get the rocks hot enough, the fire big enough, all at the same time. As I say, if archaeologists are looking for a ritual or magic process, this is it, I think. This is one of them, anyway, amongst many others.